58-year-old Roslyn Abeja would spend several hours at the only borehole at Barlonyo village waiting for her turn to fetch water. At times, like all other residents, she would walk 3 kilometers to Moroto River to fetch water from a point shared with animals. Abeja and the other residents of Barlonyo now have a cause to smile after a Dutch lady, Gabrielle van der Kamp, alias Akelo, through a local NGO, Otuke Harvest Foundation, constructed piped water in the area.
Yeah.
Roslyn says we had severe water shortages here. We would travel to fetch water from Moroto River, which is shared with animals. People struggle to get water there. Sometimes we fight. James Aluku, a person with disability, could not hide his excitement over the water project. I'm very happy, he says, for this water project. We had severe water problems. Many people were infected with lice due to poor hygiene. The water project, worth 300 million shillings, constructed with the help from the people of Holland through Otuke Harvest Foundation, was commissioned on Friday to serve over 5,000 people living within a radius of 10 kilometers. Barlonyo in Orit Parish, Angweng Sub-County, has now transformed into a big settlement with a trading center, government vocational school, primary schools, a health center. 3 is near completion. Daniel Sentamu Kabunga, the deputy RCC of Lirao, while commissioning the water project on Friday, commended the Dutch lady, saying many people are looking to her for help.
Commission it for use.
Amen.
We send our prayers. Let God provide. Such that you bring more projects. This is now here in Barlonyo, but I know very many sub-counties, they are on us.
Kamp explains how she was moved to raise funds for the water project. The NGO trained the villagers in financial management and helped them form groups where they save every week and borrow from their own savings to start small businesses.
Teach them how to take care of your money so that they're not overspending it. So they will also save the money within the group. But we also teach them that they have to keep some budget at home when they need medical care. We also encourage them to take their children to school.
Jen Oroma, the project officer, says they are dealing with the war victims through the VSLA groups. They are given psychosocial support to help them recover from the traumatic experience they went through. Richard Okelo Orik, the Lira District LC5 chairperson, observes that the district had water coverage of about 80%, but as people returned home after guns went silent, several boreholes broke down.
So we are fighting to eliminate water shortages. Clean water source will be available for everybody.
The water project sits on land donated by the Anglican Church with a 42,000-liter tank installed. Report by Hudson Aponyo for the news.